हेलो एंड वेलकम बैक टू अन एकेडमी। सो लेट्स क्रैक नीट पीजी। माय सेल्फ डॉक्टर मुस्कान चौधरी एंड टुडे विल बी कवरिंग सम क्वेश्चंस फ्रॉम द एम्स एग्जामिनेशन दैट हैज बीन आस्क्ड प्रीवियस इन प्रीवियस इयर्स, राइट? सो फ्यू क्वेश्चंस वी कवर्ड एंड नाउ सिंस एग्जामिनेशन INICT इज ओवर आवर हेड, सो विल बी कवरिंग द प्रीवियस एग्जामिनेशन सो दैट वील कम टू नो द इम्पॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चंस दैट हैज बीन आस्क्ड एंड द इम्पॉर्टेंट टॉपिक्स फ्रॉम विच फ्रीक्वेंटली द क्वेश्चंस बीइंग आस्क्ड रेगुलरली। ओके, माय सेल्फ डॉक्टर मुस्कान चौधरी एंड करंटली फर्स्ट ईयर रेजिडेंट एट SMS हॉस्पिटल जयपुर एंड टेक्निकली सेकेंड ईयर, जस्ट वेटिंग फॉर द जूनियर्स टू कम एंड आई एम ऑल्सो बींग लेट टू बी प्रमोटेड टू अ सेकेंड ईयर फॉर दैट सेम रीजन एज वेल। So right, so as we know that An Academy is India's largest learning platform and India's largest learning platform where you can assess both the live and the recorded sessions. It is mainly beneficial for those students who are at the periphery and the medical officers and doing their JRship and they have limited period of time for themselves to prepare for the examinations. They can watch the recorded sessions and can watch the recorded sessions whenever they get the time during the OPDs and get their time during the in the wards, right? And that too learning from the topmost India's educator, as An Academy has so many educators on their platform that you can choose whatever you from wherever you want to study and have personalize your learning experience from a favorite educator, because every student has their own skill of learning things and they connect with their own educators, so you can just choose your favorite one. Competing in the live TNEs and testing your preparation with the highly competitive exams, because An Academy is not only a single competitive exam platform that is helping you to prepare only for the medical examination, but also for the other all the other examinations. For any examination, competitive exam, you just name that, and An Academy is ready to teach you on that. All right, so you can assess up to 25,000 of the MCQs. All right, and you need to cover up 50 to 100 MCQs, 50 to 100 MCQs per day, getting a score of 18,000 MCQs to cover just before the examination, so that even if you doesn't know the topic, you must remember the questions that have been repeatedly being asked. All right. Now, soon printed notes will be provided by the An Academy on the NEET PG platform. With the icon subscriptions. Now, An Academy and PrepLadder has come together under the iconic subscriptions, and as we know that PrepLadder is one of the topmost institutes coaching platform when we talk about the NEET PG examinations, where you get the rapid revision snapshots and we get the Q banks and we get the video lectures and clinically and integrated essentials with the 2022 Dream Notes. All right, with well-structured live batches, recorded sessions, and the Q banks of the An Academy, with competitive TNDs and comprehensive and the printed digital notes. All right, please do use my code that is Muskan10 to get 10% of the discount on the NEET PG subscription. On the NEET PG subscriptions. Now, I will request for those students who are in the second year and the third year examination and the MBBS professional examinations, they can actually choose to opt for 4 year subscriptions. And if under plus, it will be costing, there has been price hike from the 1st of October. You can choose 4 year subscriptions because it will eventually take you 3 to 4 years from second year to go for the examination. So you have enough of the time to cover out your basics, simultaneously prepare for the professional examination with the help of the An Academy platform. With 12-month subscriptions, you get 2 months totally free, and with 24-month subscriptions, you get 4 months totally free subscription. All right, and please do use my code that is Muskan10 to get 10% of the discount. Now, there has been a price hike, and for 1 year it will be costing you around 52,500. For 18 months, it will be around 57,500. For 2 years, it will be 65,000. For 36 months, after 36 months, it is about 75, and for 4 years, it is 85,000. Use my code that is Muskan10 to get 10% of the discount on the NEET PG subscriptions. All right, so we'll cover some important questions. The remaining of the some few important questions that we'll cover today. And coming to the first question now. All right, So first question, I'll give around 20 seconds to every question. So first question that will start today. Okay, the endotoxin of which of the following gram-negative bacteria doesn't play any part in the pathogenesis of the natural disease that is E. coli, Klebsiella, Vibrio cholera, and the Pseudomonas. So we are talking about the endotoxin. ठीक है, सो पहले अपन बात करते हैं किसकी, एंडोटॉक्सिन की. एंड वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द ग्राम नेगेटिव ऑर्गेनिज्म. वी नो दैट एंड ग्राम नेगेटिव ऑर्गेनिजम्स हैज व्हाट, आउटर मेम्ब्रेन. और आउटर मेम्ब्रेन में क्या होता है, एलपीएस होता है, दैट इज द लाइपोपॉलीसेक्राइड इज प्रेजेंट एंड इट हैज ओ सी एंड ए सब टाइप्स इन दैट ऑफ द लाइपोपॉलीसेक्राइड एंड ए इज हैविंग व्हाट, एंडोटॉक्सिन लाइक एक्टिविटी. ठीक है, नाउ वी हैव टू रिकॉग्नाइज दैट ग्राम नेगेटिव ऑर्गेनिज्म दैट हैविंग द एंडोटॉक्सिन दैट डजंट प्ले एनी पार्ट इन द पैथोजेनेसिस. कमिंग टू इकोलाइट, Klebsiella, Vibrio cholerae, and the Pseudomonas all are the gram negative, but in the Vibrio cholera, the cholera, the rice watery stools, that we see, watery diarrhea, sorry, that watery diarrhea that we see is actually due to cholera toxin, and it is not an endotoxin, it is an enterotoxin. It is an enterotoxin. All right, so the correct answer will be what? Vibrio cholera. It causes what? The LPS, but it endotoxin doesn't have any pathogenicity, doesn't have any pathogenicity for causing cholera. The watery diarrhea of the cholera is resulting due to the action of the cholera toxin, due to the cholera toxin, and it is what? It is a protein. Enterotoxin that is produced by the organism where in the small intestine. So होता क्या है कि the enterotoxin is having two subunits A and B. ठीक है, याद रखो B से is helping in the binding. तो B will bind with the GM1 receptors that are present on the epithelial cells of the small intestine. वहां पे जाके bind हो जाएगा and after binding the A subunit will break down into A1 and A2 and it will activate it. A1 will go inside and will increase the level of the CAM, will increase the level of what? CAM, and will cause what? Will cause the release, increase what? The level of the chlorine and the water. ठीक है, and will cause the electrolyte imbalance, will cause the electrolyte and the water imbalance, causing hypersecretion of the water. So this is what is happening here. This is what is happening here. That is a cholera toxin. That is what? Enterotoxin having the A and the B subunit. B will bind with G1 receptors and A will actually, this will be taken down by endocytosis by the epithelial cell and will increase the level of the CAM and this will cause the secretion of the chlorine. And after that, water following the osmolarity will cause what? The watery diarrhea. Watery diarrhea. ठीक है, and it is not due to endotoxin. It is not due to the endotoxin. It is due to what? Enterotoxin. That is enterotoxin. That is what? Cholera toxin. Easy to remember, क्योंकि cholera हो रहा है, that is intestinal problem is taking place. So it is what? Enterotoxin. It is something that is related with what? Intestine. Now coming to the next question. Aerosol spread leading to epidemic. Now, looking at the question, just note one, two things. One, we are talking about the aerosol, and second thing, we are talking about the epidemic. ठीक है, are seen in the infection with Legionella Haemophilus influenza and the mycoplasma. There may be certain options that having the aerosol spread among these, but we are also at the same time we are also talking about the epidemic. So look after these 2 points when you are checking out the answer. So just take your time of 20 seconds and do let me know. Okay, so what will be the answer? Legionella influenza mycoplasma in the Legionella as well as it is also aerosol spread, but it doesn't cause an epidemic. Neither the influenza, this mycoplasma and Haemophilus, but influenza ke 3 subtypes hota, that is A, B and C, and they are the responsible for causing the epidemics, right? So influenza aerosol spread is taking place and they leads to the epidemics that has been seen previously. Now, causative organism is what? Orthomyxovirus, and it has 3 subtypes, that is A, B, and C. That is A, B, and C. And most common for causing the epidemic is subtype A. ठीक है, ऑल राइट. सो मोस्ट कॉमन फॉर कॉजिंग द एपिडेमिक और आउटब्रेक इज वॉट? टाइप ए. And what is the cause of causing the pandemic is what? Type B. All right. Type C is not circulating currently, and the incubation period for them is about 18 to 72 hours, and the period of infectivity is 1 to 2 days before to 1 to 2 days after the onset of symptoms. So what we have to remember that orthomyxovirus causing the influenza is aerosol spreading. Aerosol is the mode of the transmission, and the A, B, and C subtypes, that is A is most common for causing the outbreak and epidemic. For the pandemic, it is what? Type B and C is currently we are not talking about it because they are at such there it doesn't cause any epidemic. Now, when we talk about the legion are very important, please remember very important that we need to remember that whenever in the question the history is given that AC has been implanted recently, right? And after that, the patient is sick, something like that is related with the water tower or evaporative condensers or AC implant. Then one of the option जो अपने दिमाग में आना चाहिए is what? Legionella. ठीक है. नाउ लीजियोनेला यू कैन सी दैट इट इज आल्सो बाय द एरोसोल स्प्रेड, बट वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द एपिडेमिक. लीजियोनेला इज नॉट स्प्रेड बाय ह्यूमन टू ह्यूमन इंटरेक्शन. मिस्ट और वेपर कंटेनिंग द बैक्टीरिया इज रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर द मोड ऑफ द ट्रांसमिशन, एंड वार्म स्टेगनेंट वाटर इज आइडियल फॉर द स्प्रेड, राइट. नाउ अनदर इज वॉट वी टॉकिंग अबाउट? हीमोफिलिस. ठीक है, वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द हीमोफिलिस. नाउ व्हाट इज द मोड ऑफ ट्रांसमिशन हियर? द मोड ऑफ ट्रांसमिशन इज व्हाट? मोड ऑफ ट्रांसमिशन इज व्हाट? ड्रॉपलेट एंड डिस्चार्ज और व्हाट? अपर रेस्पिरेटरी ट्रैक्ट फ्रॉम द इन्फेक्शियस पर्सन, राइट. एंड इंक्यूबेशन पीरियड एज लॉन्ग एज द ऑर्गेनिज्म इज प्रेजेंट इवन इन द एब्सेंस ऑफ द नेजल डिस्चार्ज बिकॉज इट इज ऑल्सो नॉन इन्फेक्शियस बिटवीन 20. Between 24 to 48 hours after the effective antibiotics. Now, one is the mycoplasma. Okay, now if you remember from the mycoplasma, when we know that what is the colony morphology, they show the fried egg colonies. Please remember this, they show what? Fried egg colonies due to the absence of what? Due to absence of the cell wall. Now, etiological agent for the disease known as the primary atypical pneumonia, that is the walking pneumonia, and it is mainly a lower respiratory tract infection. Mode of transmission is what? Person to person, by the contact with the respiratory secretions. And epidemiology, it is worldwide and casually it is sporadic. Highest incidence is amongst the children, that is the young adults. All right. So mycoplasma pneumonia is what causing what? Walking pneumonia, that is a lower respiratory tract infection, and it is mainly by the spread. The mode is mainly by the contact with the respiratory secretions. Okay, now coming to the next question, that which of the following feature is not shared between the T and the B cells? That positive selections during development, class 1 MHC expression, and antigen specific receptors, and all of the above. So which of the following is not shared between T and B cells? So which of the following is not shared? When we studied about autoimmunity, हमने दो तीन चीजें देखी थी, वन फॉर द बी सेल एंड अनदर फॉर द टी सेल. कि ऑटो इम्यूनिटी में जो टॉलरेंस होता है, टू टाइप्स ऑफ टॉलरेंस इज देयर. वन इज द सेंट्रल टॉलरेंस एंड अनदर इज वॉट पेरिफेरल टॉलरेंस. ठीक है, तो दो तरह के टॉलरेंस होते हैं, वन इज द सेंट्रल, अनदर इज द पेरिफेरल टॉलरेंस. एंड वहां पे सेंट्रल टॉलरेंस में क्या होता है, लाइक बी सेल इज गेटिंग मैच्योर वेयर इन द बोन मैरो, एंड टी सेल्स आर गेटिंग मैच्योर वेयर इन द थाइमस. तो वहां पे नेगेटिव सिलेक्शन होता है, पॉजिटिव सिलेक्शन होता है. सो दैट वॉट एवर द बी सेल्स एंड द टी सेल्स दैट हैज बीन फॉर्म्ड एंड दे आर सेल्फ रिएक्टिंग रिएक्टिव दैट इज एक्टिंग अगेंस्ट आर ओन सेल्फ एंटीजन, they are negatively selected and they are moved to the apoptosis, right? So that is possible for both the B cell and the T cell. But along with the B cell and the T cell also have what? Positive selection, right? So which of the following is not shared? Positive selection during development. Positive selection during development for the central tolerance, right, is only possible for the T cell, not for the B cell. So this option is actually not true. Now, positive selections during development, B cell undergo negative. Okay, positive selection during development, B cell undergo negative selections, whereas T cell undergoes both the positive as well as a negative selection. Now, what is the mechanism of the central tolerance? हमने देखा था. Okay, हमने देखा था कि the recognition of the antigens by the immature B cells in the bone marrow is critical to the development of the immunological tolerance to the cell. Because one of the basic method of the autoimmunity, जो फर्स्ट जो मैकेनिज्म होता है, जो स्टार्ट होता है, वो सेंट्रल टॉलरेंस से स्टार्ट होता है. जब इनिशियली जब डेवलप होती है बी सेल्स एंड द टी सेल्स, द बी सेल्स दैट आर रिएक्टिव अगेंस्ट सेल्फ एंटीजन्स आर नेगेटिवली सिलेक्टेड and they are excluded by the apoptosis. Same for the T cells. Now for proper immunological functions, it is essential that B cells doesn't recognize the self antigens and should recognize antigen that has been derived from the pathogens. In the bone marrow, the immature B cells bearing surface IgM, if it recognizes self molecule, undergoes what? Undergoes the negative selection. So this is what we are talking about. This self antigens induces the loss of the cell from the B cell repertoire and is called clonal deletion. This is what called the self antigen that induces the loss of the B cells. This is called as a clonal deletion, and thus only B cells that doesn't recognize the self molecules comes out of the bone marrow. Although 10% of the B cells that are self reactive also goes to the periphery, but they are then negatively removed through the peripheral tolerance that we talked in the autoimmunity class. Now, when we talk about the T cell tolerance, T cells are selective for the survival more rigorously than the B cells, and they undergoes both positive and नेगेटिव सेलेक्शन. ऑल राइट, एंड वेयर द मैच्योरेशन इज टेकिंग प्लेस वेयर इन थाइमस. सो सेंट्रल टॉलरेंस इज टेकिंग प्लेस वेयर इन द थाइमस. नाउ टी सेल टॉलरेंस इज इंड्यूस्ड इन द थाइमस एंड द पॉजिटिव सेलेक्शन अकर्स इन द कॉर्टेक्स. इफ मैच्योरिंग टी सेल्स इज एबल टू फाइंड सरफेस एमएचसी मॉलिक्यूल, इट इज सेव्ड फ्रॉम प्रोग्राम सेल डेथ दैट इज कॉल्ड एपोप्टोसिस, वेयर सेल्स फेल्स टू रिकग्नाइज द एमएचसी, दे विल डाई. नाउ पॉजिटिव सेलेक्शन इंश्योर्स दैट टी सेल रिकग्नाइजेस एंटीजन इन एसोसिएशन विद द एमएचसी मॉलिक्यूल. नाउ नेगेटिव सेलेक्शन इज रिक्वायर्ड क्योंकि जो भी टी सेल्स दे आर रिएक्टिव अगेंस्ट आर ऑन एंटीजन, दे आर नेगेटिवली सेलेक्टेड एंड आर रिमूव्ड. बट वाई पॉजिटिव सेलेक्शन इज रिक्वायर्ड, बिकॉज वी नो दैट टी सेल इज एक्चुअली वॉट इज वन ऑफ द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट सेल दैट रिकग्नाइजेस द एंटीजन प्रेजेंटिंग सेल having the antigen, and this will be presented to what MHC class. All right, so therefore the cells that are able to recognize the MHC molecule, they are positively selected, and that are not, they are moved to the cell death. Now positive selection, it ensures that T cell recognizes antigen in association with the MHC molecule, because this is the basis for the immunity. Now negative selections occurs where in the cortex, medulla and the cortico-medullary junctions. Here, the medullary thymic epithelial cell signals self-reactive T cells to die via apoptosis, and on B cell surface, IgE acts as an antigenic receptors, where TCR along with CD3 act as antigenic receptors. So just remember the basic point that T cell and B cell mature ka honge, T cell T40 thymus mein, and B cell will mature in the bone marrow. T cell is selectively both positive and the negative, and B cell is only negatively selective during the developmental phase. Now, with reference to bacteroids fragilis, the following statements are true, except one is that bacteroids fragilis is the same frequent anaerobic isolated from the clinical samples, is not uniformly sensitive to metronidazole. The lipopolysaccharides formed by the fragilis is structurally and functionally different from the conventional endotoxins, and the shock and the disseminated intravascular coagulations are common in the bacteroids bacteremia. So this is again the question that has been asked in the AIIMS examination previously. So take your time and just let me know the answer. All right, so we have to find the exception. So first, coming to each of the options one by one, that is, first is it is the same frequent anaerobe that is isolated from the clinical sample. So let consider that we doesn't know ki such hai ya true or false. Coming to the next option, that it is not uniformly sensitive, any of the microbe is not uniformly sensitive to any of the antibiotic. All right, so this is true. और जो इफ यू कैन कंसिडर जो आपको नहीं पता ये इट इज ट्रू. ठीक है ना, कमिंग टू लास्ट टू ऑप्शंस, वन वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द एंडोटॉक्सिन एंड अनदर वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द इफेक्ट्स ऑफ द एंडोटॉक्सिन. सो दिस इज द क्वेश्चन, जिसमें दो ऑप्शन तो एंडोटॉक्सिन के बारे में है. सो इट विल इंडिकेट अस कि अपन को इन दोनों में से कोई आंसर ढूंढना है. नाउ दिस इज ट्रू दैट द लाइपोपॉलीसैकेराइड ऑफ बैक्टीरियल फ्रैजिलिस इज स्ट्रक्चरली डिफरेंट फ्रॉम द कन्वेंशनल एलपीएस फ्रॉम कन्वेंशनल एंडोटॉक्सिन, एंड देयरफॉर द एंडोटॉक्सिन ऑफ द बैक्टीरियल fragilis is not actually causing the effects like shock and the intravascular coagulations causing DIC and the shock. So अभी अपन एंडोटॉक्सिन पे दो क्वेश्चन पढ़ लिए, एंड इट मीन्स दैट वी नीड टू गेट इन द डिटेल अबाउट द जनरल बैक्टीरियोलॉजी एज वेल. ठीक है, सो शॉक एंड द डिसएमिनेटेड डीआईसी आर कॉमन इन द बैक्टीरियोइड्स. दिस इज false, because bacteroids have the lipopolysaccharides but they actually lack the endotoxic activity, they lack the endotoxin activity. All right, and the LPS are much less toxic than those of the normally gram negative bacteria. There's infections that doesn't directly produce the clinical signs of the sepsis shock, and when these clinical signs appears in the infection, they are result of what? Inflammatory immune response. All right, Now, coming to the next question, a 30-year-old farmer from the sub-Himalayan region presents with multiple leg ulcer. The most causative agent is what? Trichophyton rubrum, Cladosporium species, Sporothrix schenkii, or the Aspergillus. All right. So I'll just give you 20 seconds. Just take your time and do let me know the answer. ठीक है, तो हमको क्या क्या नोट डाउन करना है. वन इज दैट वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द ओल्ड फार्मर, वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द फार्मर. वन इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट इज दैट वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट फार्मर, एंड अनदर थिंग इज दैट वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट सब हिमालयन रीजन दैट इज प्रेजेंटिंग व्हाट लैग अल्सर्स. दीज क्लिनिकल सिम्टम्स, दीज आर क्लिनिकल, दीज क्लिनिकल हिस्ट्री इज एक्चुअली पॉइंटिंग टूवर्ड्स द स्पोरोथ्रिक्स शांकी. ऑलराइट, नाउ when we talk about the Sporothrix schenkii, it is what? It is actually a dimorphic fungus. When we'll talk about the fungus, when we'll cover about the fungus, there is a mnemonic for this dimorphic fungus that what that is. Sporothrix schenkii is a fungus that can be worldwide, and the most common mode is what? Through the spread of the spores, that is the introduction of the spores, mainly through traumatic puncture. All right, and the frequent has a history of the trauma that is associated with gardening, farming, planting, and the initial lesion is actually located on the extremities. All right, it is located on the extremities. Now, 75% cases are lymphocutaneous, and the initial lesion develops to what? Granulomatous nodule, and this may proceed to what? Ulcerative lesion. Mainly along the lymph nodes, mainly along the lymph nodes. This is the key point that we need to remember, that the draining lymph nodes, the draining lymph nodes, they become what? They become thick. All right, and oral itraconazole is the treatment of the choice. Multiple nodules and abscess occurs along the lymphatics. This is the most important image we need to remember, because sometimes this image is given. You can clearly see the granulomatous nodules, that is, and the thickened lymph nodes, that is, along the line of the lymph nodes. You can see the nodules in the Sporothrix schenkii. Now, coming to the next question, a 30-year-old farmer presents with the feature of the high fever, painful inguinal lymphadenopathy, vomiting, diarrhea with hypotension. Which of the following stain may be helpful in the diagnosis? That is Vicens stain, Neisser stain, Albert stain, and McFadden reaction stain. सो वॉट वी हैव टू नोट पे तो स्टेन्स देखो, नीजर्स एंड एल्बर्ट स्टेन अपन कहाँ यूज करते हैं? वी यूज फॉर द कॉर्नी बैक्टीरियम डिप्थीरिया. नाउ सिंस इट इज सिंगल चॉइस क्वेश्चन एंड बोथ आर स्टेन फॉर द सेम ऑर्गेनिज्म, सो यू कैन एक्सक्लूड कि दिस इज नॉट द आंसर. एंड द कॉर्नी बैक्टीरियम डिप्थीरिया, द क्लिनिकल हिस्ट्री इज नॉट रिलेटेड विद द फार्मर. ठीक है, सो वी कैन एक्सक्लूड दीज टू ऑप्शन. नाउ कमिंग बैक टू द वाइसेन स्टेन एंड द मैकफाइडन स्टेन दैट इज यूज फॉर बेसिलस. क्या देखते हैं अपन? कैप्सूल देखते हैं मैकफाइडन स्टेन में. दैट इज बाय यूजिंग पॉलीक्रोम मिथाइलिन ब्लू स्टेन वी सी व्हाट? वी सी द कैप्सूल. एंड द वाइसिन स्टेन इज इट फॉर यारसीनिया, दैट इज फॉर प्लेग. All right, now come to the now we have come to the two options we are left with. That is, one is the bacillus and the Yersinia. Now coming to the clinical history, that he has the features of the high fever and the painful inguinal lymphadenopathy. These all vomiting with the diarrhea. These are indicating towards the plague. So what will the answer? The answer will be Vicens stain. Now it is what it is actually a methylene blue basic fusion stain, and it is a modified methylene blue stain used for the diagnosis of what bubonic plague. And Vicens stains reveals the typical safety pin appearance of the organism. Reveals what the safety pin appearance. Safety pin appearance. Okay. Now, actually, in bubonic plague, the infected flea bite is usually on the legs and is marked on the by a small pustule on the ulceration. More often, the lymph nodes draining the area becomes affected, and the resulting adenitis produces painful swelling or bubose on the inguinal lymph region, depending upon the position of the bite by the infected flea. Now you can see we are staining with the Vicens stain or the methylene blue stain, and you can clearly see the safety pin appearance bipolar staining of the Yersinia. Now talking about the Cornibacterium diphtheria, we know Cornibacterium diphtheria is what V letter or a V letter or the P letter or the L letter having the bipolar granules, metachromatic granules, all right, and Wolff's Ernest granules that is having in Cornibacterium diphtheria, and mainly they show what the appearance of the membrane, that is the tough leathery membrane in the pharynx. And there are four major species that are subspecies are Cornibacterium diphtheria mitis, intermediatus, gravis, and the Bel fanti. Right, and what is the culture media? One is the potassium telluride agar, that is a PTA agar that we are using, and on the basis of the PTA agar we can classify the Cornibacterium diphtheria into the gravis, intermediates, and the mitis on the basis of the colony formation on the PTA agar due to reduction of the potassium telluride to that of the tellurium by the Cornibacterium diphtheria. Now another is what we are talking about, Bacillus anthracis, and we know it causes what three types. One is what cutaneous anthrax, gastrointestinal anthrax, and inhalation anthrax. Okay, in the cutaneous anthrax we'll see what we'll see necrotic eschar with along with the surrounding edema. That is, we'll see a necrotic black eschar with surrounding edema. Very important in the cutaneous anthrax. Inhalation anthrax is the most poor prognostic and the fatal. That is, inhalation anthrax early is non-specific with the fever, cough, and myalgia, and late will show the enlargement of the lymph nodes with meningeal symptoms. In the GIT, depending upon the upper GIT and the lower GIT, showing what the lymphadenopathy, edema, sore throat, and with the pseudo membrane. In the lower, the ileum, cecum, and causing what nausea, vomiting, and the bloody diarrhea. Okay, and what is it is encapsulated, we see by McFadden reaction, that we see what in the McFadden reaction. We will see what? We will see the capsule around the organism and bacillus. What is the structure? Bamboo shaped appearance of the bacillus with the central spore, and we'll see a capsule, purple color capsule around that of the bacillus anthracis. Now coming to the next question, and abattoir and abattoir. Worker presented with a malignant pustule on his hand that progressed to form an ulcer. Smear was taken and sent to laboratory. The diagnosis is cutaneous anthrax, carbuncle, ulcerating melanoma, or infected rodent ulcer. Take your time and just let me know what will be the answer here. What is the key point that we need to see here? We are talking about the abattoir worker. Abattoir कौन? स्लॉटर पीपल, स्लॉटर मैन. ठीक है, स्लॉटर मैन. ऑल राइट, दैट्स सॉर्ट आउट दैट मीट, दैट कट डाउन द मीट, दैट इज अ स्लॉटर मैन वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट. एंड दे प्रेजेंटेड वॉट अ मेलिग्नेंट पुस्टुल. नाउ वेयर अवे क्लिनिकल हिस्ट्री समथिंग लाइक दिस कम दैट अ वर्कर इज एन एबटॉय वर्कर, दैन इट इज मेनली इट इज इंडिकेटेड टू वर्ड्स वॉट, क्यूटेनियस एंथ्रेक्स. वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट anthrax. All right, now anthrax is what? Zoonotic disease that is caused by the bacillus that occurs mainly by the herbivorous. Root, what is the root? Human becomes infected when spores are introduced in the body. We just saw that is either by the contact with the animal, contact with the animal containing the infected spore with the insect bites, by ingestion and by inhalation. All right, by insect bite, ingestion, inhalation, and the contact with the infected animals. And the clinical forms, as we saw, one is the cutaneous, that is the most common, GIT and inhalation. And another, wool sorters disease, causing what? Wool sorters disease. Now, the most, it is what? An occupational hazard. It is what? An occupational hazard. And most dangerous form is what? Inhalational. ठीक है, इट इज दैट इज अ हाई पॉटर डिजीज. व्हाट इज दैट? इट इज कॉज्ड बाय द कॉन्टेक्ट विद द कंटेमिनेटेड हेयर वूल प्रोडक्ट्स. मैलिगेंट पुस्टुल कॉमनली दैट इज सीन वेयर इन द हेड एंड द नेक. ऑलराइट, एस्कार स्टेज दैट अपियर्स अबाउट 2 to 6 days आफ्टर द हीमरेजिक वेसिकल्स, ट्राइज टू बिकम डिप्रेस्ड ब्लैक स्कैब दैट इज सराउंडेड बाय इडिमा, सराउंडेड बाय द रेडनेस. Now, what is the diagnosis? Presumptive diagnosis is made by staining it what? Polychrome methylene blue stain, that is a MacFadden reaction. That's what? MacFadden reaction. This is what the MacFadden reaction, as I told you, you can clearly see what? The capsule around the organism containing what? Polychrome methylene blue stain, staining with what? Polychrome methylene blue stain. All right, the MacFadden reaction, when blood film containing the anthrax bacilli stained with polychrome methylene blue stain and amorphous purple material is noticed around the bacilli. This represents the capsule material is characteristic of the anthrax. Culture characteristic that is on agar will show what? Frosted glass appearance. Frosted glass appearance. And on the gelatin stab culture, we just saw types of the culture: inoculation, stab, stalk, lawn, and the streak. And it is what? Inverted fire tea appearance. Jaise kisi ne stab kiya, also it is what? Stab culture to see what? Gelatin liquefaction. This is the bacillus anthracis string of pearl appearance on the blood media, and this is the same, that is a frosted glass appearance. Frosted glass appearance. All right, this is what? String of pearl appearance. String of pearl appearance. All right, and this differentiates what? Bacillus anthracis from the cereus, and the selective media is what? Blood media containing polymyxin, lysozyme, EDT and thallus acetate. All right, containing what? Polymyxin, lysozyme, EDT and thallus acetate. Now this is what? This is the string of pearl appearance. String of pearl appearance. The medusa head appearance is also seen where? In the bacillus anthracis. Now please remember, it is what? It is what? Bacillus and the Clostridium both shows what? Spore formation. And we remembered B se B is what? Non-bulging spores. Is what? Non-bulging spores. Clostridium will show what? Bulging spores. So they show what? Non-bulging spores. Alright, with the bamboo shape appearance, morphology, string of pearl appearance, frosted glass appearance, and it is mainly by ingestion, inhalation, and insect bite, contact with the infected animal, and the most dangerous route is what? Inhalation, causing the wool sorters disease. Now, which of the following is correct? Which of the following is correct? अबाउट प्रियॉन्स, दैट इज हैविंग द लॉन्ग इंक्यूबेशन पीरियड, दे आर डिस्ट्रॉयड बाय द ऑटोक्लेव, दे हैविंग न्यूक्लिक एसिड एंड दे अबाउट नॉन दे अबाउट इम्यूनोजेनिक. सो टेक योर टाइम एंड जस्ट लेट मी नो द आंसर. तो क्या रहेगा इसका आंसर, विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग इज करेक्ट, वी हैव टू फाइंड द करेक्ट स्टेटमेंट आउट दैट दे आर डिस्ट्रॉयड बाय ऑटोक्लेविंग. दे आर डिस्ट्रॉयड बाय द ऑटोक्लेविंग बट एट द टेम्परेचर ऑफ 134 डिग्री सेल्सियस फॉर 1 आवर. इसके अलावा और कौन से मेथड सोचते हैं, दैट इज द हाइपोक्लोराइट 0.5% हाइपोक्लोराइट फॉर 1 आवर एंड अनदर इज वॉट, अनदर इज वॉट सोडियम हाइड्रोक्साइड फ्रॉम 1 to 2 आवर, दैट इज 1 एंड सोडियम हाइड्रोक्साइड. दीज थ्री मैथड्स, वन इज ऑटोक्लेव, सोडियम हाइपोक्लोराइड एंड द सोडियम हाइड्रोक्साइड. ठीक है, सो दीज आर द मैथड्स टू डिस्ट्रॉय द प्रियॉन्स एंड ऑटोक्लेविंग मस्ट बी डन एट द हाइएस्ट टेम्परेचर फॉर द प्रियॉन्स बिकॉज दे आर मोस्ट रेजिस्टेंट, दे आर द मोस्ट रेजिस्टेंट प्रियॉन्स. प्रियॉन्स के बाद दूसरा कौन सा मोस्ट रेजिस्टेंट होता है, दैट इज वॉट बैक्टीरियल स्पोर्स. एंड वॉट इज द लीस्ट रेजिस्टेंट, वॉट इज द लीस्ट रेजिस्टेंट, इट वॉज एनवेलप्ड वायरस, एनवेलप्ड वायरस. और उसके बाद क्या चीज सेकेंड मोस्ट रेजिस्टेंट, लीस्ट रेजिस्टेंट इज वॉट, वेजिटेटिव बैक्टीरियल फॉर्म. ठीक है, सो दिस इज फॉल्स, दे डजेंट हैव द न्यूक्लिक एसिड, दे डजेंट हैव द न्यूक्लिक एसिड एंड दे आर वॉट नॉन इम्यूनोजेनिक, दे आर वॉट नॉन इम्यूनोजेनिक एंड दे हैव द लॉन्ग इंक्यूबेशन पीरियड. नाउ क्लिनिकल इलनेस इज प्रेसिडेड बाय द लॉन्ग इंक्यूबेशन पीरियड एंड दे आर द ओनली इन्फेक्शियस पैथोजेंस दैट इज डिवॉइड ऑफ वॉट न्यूक्लिक एसिड, दैट इज डिवॉइड ऑफ वॉट न्यूक्लिक एसिड. दे आर मोस्ट रेजिस्टेंट टू द फिजिकल एंड द केमिकल एजेंट्स एंड दे आर इन्फेक्शियस प्रोटीन दैट कॉजेज द डी जनरेशन ऑफ वॉट सी एन एस लैकिंग द न्यूक्लिक एसिड. Now, prions are the only known infectious pathogens. And what are the prion disease? It mainly cause neurodegenerative disease by transmissible the protein caused by the human prions related proteins. That is caused by the PRP. That is protein prions related proteins. And rarely a mutation in gene will allow the protein to be made incorrectly, and it will cause what the disease. Now, hallmark a disease is confined to what CNS. What are the basic features? One, we saw that neurodegeneration and the spongy form changes. Clinical illness is preceded by the long incubation period, and the disease is what disease is always fatal. Always fatal. They shows no immunogenic response. They shows no inflammatory response. They shows no. They are actually what non-immunogenic. They are what non-immunogenic. Now, they sporadic. They cause a sporadic spectrum of the disease. They cause sporadic CJD, and that is accounting for the 85% of the disease. Iske alawa, they also cause the GSS and the familial, the Gerstmann-Tausler's Shinker's disease, and the fatal familial insomnia. Now, when we talk about the human prions disease, they cause what the Creutzfeldt-Jakob's disease and the GSS, which we just saw, that is Gerstmann-Tausler-Shinker's disease and fatal familial insomnia. Now, animals, they cause the scrapies and the mink and cephalopathy and the chronic wasting disease. So the key points we need to remember is that they are not having the nucleic acid, they are non-immunogenic with a long incubation period, all right, and how to destroy the prions. Now coming to the next question, what is true about the OPB? What is true about the OPB except we get quick immune response, it is a live vaccine and it is used in epidemic and maternal antibodies interfere with the immune response. So which of the following is incorrect? All right, so what if which of the following is not true about this? We get a quick immune response. It is a live vaccine. It is a live vaccine and it is used during the pandemics, and the metal antibodies will interfere with the immune response. But we do not get the quick immune response. Oral polio vaccine, that is live vaccine that we are talking about, Sabin. ठीक है, द वैक्सीन प्रोजेनी इज वॉट एक्सक्रेटेड इन द फीसेस एंड द सेकेंडरी स्प्रेड अकर टू द हाउस होल्ड कॉन्टेक्ट नॉन इम्यूनाइज पर्सन में देयरफॉर बी इम्यूनाइज एंड वाइड स्प्रेड हर्ड इम्यूनिटी विल रिजल्ट इन द ब्रेकडाउन ऑफ द एपिडेमिक द प्रॉपर्टी हैज बीन एक्सप्लॉइटेड इन कंट्रोलिंग वॉट द एपिडेमिक All right, and the live vaccine. In the live vaccine, stimulate what the antibody formation in the epithelial cell and the pairs patches by activating what the local immunity. Then the virus spreads to other areas of the body and produce the antibodies. The presence of the circulating antibody may interfere with the infection created by the attenuated viruses, and the production of the antibodies takes time. Therefore, we can't get the immune response, quick immune response. So, we do not get the quick immune response. It is a live vaccine and it is used in the epidemic, and the maternal antibodies will interfere with it. Okay. Now, we'll talk. Some more questions? All right, so we'll just take a quick revision of the questions that we have already covered in previous class. Now, the first question is what? First question is what? According to transplantation of human organs, what is the punishment for a doctor that is found guilty? It is around 2 to 5 years, but in 211 Amendment Act, it has been increased to 10 years and up to 20 lakh rupees fine. Now, an elderly man is presented with the fever, dry cough, and the chest pain. The organism was detected in the charcoal yeast media. All right, so we need to remember the media for the charcoal yeast media that we are talking about. Now, what is the media that is mainly used for the, we are talking about which media? BCYE media, that is buffered charcoal yeast media, and it is used for the Legionella. It is used for what? The Legionella. Please remember this. You can see that this is the BCYE media, it is buffered charcoal yeast media, and the Legionella is used for is cultured on this media. For Haemophilus, we are using what? Chocolate agar. We are using what? Chocolate agar. And for the Moraxella as well, we are also using what? Blood agar or chocolate agar. All right. So now for Moraxella also, we are using what? Blood agar and the chocolate agar plates, and the Moraxella, the colonies will scoot across the media. This is again the blood agar, chocolate agars, and even we are using a Thayer's Martin media that we also use for the Neisseria. Now, this is another form of the Haemophilus, that is a string, the school of the fish, and railroad appearance or the tram track appearance. H influenza will show what? Where they will show the gray convex colonies, and chocolate agar is used for the growth of the Haemophilus, and it is due to the containing what? 5 to 10% of the sheep blood that is heated up to 70 degrees Celsius, that will release what? Factor number 5 that is required for the growth of the influenza Haemophilus. Now, Haemophilus is causing what? Depending on the typeable and the non-typeable, type non-typeable causing otitis media, sinusitis, and the type B that is causing meningitis, epiglottitis. Now, Baculturia is what? Selective media was BCSA. Now, which is not true with regard to antibiotic resistance in bacteria, that most common mechanism is production of antibody by destroying enzymes. Lack of target binding site may be mechanical resistance, some enterococcus against vancomycin, and the plasmid mediated resistance is transmitted only vertically. This is false because we know that plasmid is transmitted by the horizontal transfers, and what are the mechanism of the horizontal transfer? That is conjugation, transduction transformation. All right, so this is absolutely not true. Now rest of the options, that most common mechanism of production of the antibody, yes, by enzymes, and they lack in the enterococcus. Even doesn't know the rest of the three options, for sure you know this option. All right, so this we have discussed this question, we have discussed for the bacterias fragilis. Now this question is about urethral discharge, and on examination there are pus cells but no organisms. Now urethral discharge, depending, it is what, gonococcal or non-gonococcal urethral discharge, and non-gonococcal it is chlamydia. Chlamydia, that is the most common organism for causing non-gonococcal urethral discharge. Okay, McCoy cell lines are used for chlamydia. Thyroid martin media is used for the neisseria. PPLO for mycoplasma. Okay, now they are showing what, urethral discharge in the male, but pus cells are found but no organisms. That means we are talking about non-gonococcal, and it is the McCoy cell lines. Now this is thyroid martin media, this is a PPLO probe containing the penicillin polymyxin for that of the mycoplasma. This is Robertson cooked media, this is used for growth of the anaerobic bacteria containing the beef heart particles containing glutathione. Now bacteria that is coated with the complement, we are talking about the bacteria that is a pathogen that is coated with the complement, and IgG, that is means we are talking about opsonization, and it enhances the phagocytosis by C3b and Fc mediated destruction. All right, now in this question, the main we need to focus is, one, we are talking about beta hemolytic colonies, and we are talking about the gram positive coccus. So we have to rule out the options here. Now beta, alpha, beta and the gamma streptococcus, in the beta, right, we are talking about the A and B, that is streptococcus pyogenes and streptococcus A galactae. Pyogenes mein S tha, that is it is what, bacitracin sensitive, and it is not. This is how we differentiated the beta hemolysis, on the basis of the bacitracin sensitivity. This is, see, alpha mein kya kya hai, one is the viridans and another is what, pneumococci. Now viridans is overpass, we remember the mnemonic, that is viridans is resistant and pneumococci is what, sensitive. Pyogenes is having S, that is sensitive for the bacitracin. Gamma means no hemolysis, containing what, enterococcus and the non-enterococcus streptococcus. All right, in this question, one is the gram positive cocci in the chains hai to staff to ho sakta, staff kya hota hai, clusters mein. Next is the catalase negative, therefore staff cannot be the answers, and the next option is that is having what, central venous line, and it is the enterococcus faecalis, that is actually in mode of infection is through central venous line, so we can rule out the option. First chemical barrier is what, acidic pH. Biological indicator for the autoclaving is what, Bacillus steothermophilus. Hyperacute rejection is what, due to preformed antibodies. And kaise yaad kiya tha, hyperacute is like two dande, so that is hypersensitivity is type 2, hypersensitivity is hyperacute is type 2. Acute, chronic and GVHD is what, type 4, but chronic is also type 3 and type 4. All right, so we are done with today's session. It was short, a session containing few of the questions that has been asked previously in the AIIMS examination, and please do use my code to get 10% of the discount. And please do like, share, and subscribe. I wish that those who have prepared hard and give the examination have dropped in the result. On the 10th of this October at 11 AM, we are having scholarship examination from the Unacademy platform. 60 minutes examination containing 45 questions, and I wish all the participants good luck, and please do enroll into the this session. Please enroll into the scholarship program to get the scholarship up to full scholarship 100% plus a subscription is possible for you guys. You just have to enroll and use my code, that is Muskan10, to enroll to give the examination and give your best for the paper so that you get the scholarship. Already you are preparing, so why not just give another test? It's just similar to that of the mini test that we give just for 1 hour. Just give your best shot for the examination and boost your preparation by getting the good rank in it, because we need to analyze the performances, we need to analyze our preparation, and why not to get the scholarship through it as well. So see you in the next class. Take care and bye bye.